My name is Andrea Sabido, and I'm a PhD student from the Institute of Biotechnology at the Universidad Nacional Autónoma de México.
Hello, my name is Juan Carlos Sigala from Universidad Autónoma Metropolitana, Unidad Coajimalpa. Through this video, we will show you the highlights of the recently accepted paper entitled
Physiological and Transcriptional Characterization of E. coli Strains Lacking Interconversion of Phosphoenolpyruvate and Pyruvate When Glucose and Acetate Are Co-utilized.
In this work, we describe features of the physiology of E. coli strains devoid of the major glucose transport system in bacteria, the PTS system, during simultaneous utilization of glucose and acetate. We also provide information regarding their metabolic plasticity when carbon conversion between phosphoenolpyruvate and pyruvate is blocked. And finally, we evaluated the impact of these genetic modifications on phosphoenolpyruvate availability by overproducing aromatic compounds on an engineered strains.
In our group, we're interested in E. coli metabolism to develop metabolic engineering strategies to produce valuable compounds. For this reason, two E. coli mutants devoid of PTS were generated, the PB11 and PB12 strains. Both strains can, in theory, double PEP availability, which is one of the precursors of the aromatic compounds. However, due to the elimination of the PTS system, glucose transport and growth rates in the PB11 strain decrease significantly on glucose. To overcome this limitation, an adaptive evolution process on PB11 was performed and the PB12 strain was obtained, which partially recovered its growth rate on glucose compared with its parental strain. Due to the elimination of the 2A glucose component from the PTS system, these strains can consume simultaneously secondary carbon sources in the presence of glucose. Taking into account this capacity, we additionally block the PK, PKF, and PPS genes and describe the effects of these knockout mutations on the physiology of E. coli PTS minus strains during co-utilization of glucose and acetate. In response to these knockout mutations, growth and specific consumption rates decrease significantly in the PB11 derivative compared with its parental strain. In addition, we show that genes involving transport and consumption of acetate, as well as some glycolytic genes, are downregulated when there is not intervention of PEP and PIR. The same genetic modifications in the evolved PB12 derivative did not substantially affect these parameters during co-utilization of glucose and acetate. In fact, transcription of most genes did not change and only few were overexpressed. In this manuscript, we also demonstrated that by performing such mutations, phosphoenolpyruvate derived from glucose catabolism can be directed towards the aromatic compound's biosynthetic pathway. The engineered strain derived from PB12, PK-, PKF-, PPS- enhance the final titer and yield of aromatic compounds when co-utilizing glucose and acetate.
Thanks for watching this video.
If you have any questions, please contact us. Bye.
Bye.